She was very open about the fact that she was terminally ill and she was dying. That made some of us very uncomfortable and some of us not so uncomfortable, but we never once discussed it together. I don't know if it was, when I think about it now, I think it was probably, you know, a fear we had, or, you know, just a very, I think, nervousness around, we don't want to offend her, we don't want to say something out of place, we just want to know what she wants at the end of her life. But we really, when I think about it now, would have benefited from the ability to come together as a family and have that conversation about her death. And for me, I think it's absolutely critical that families do that. The missing gap for me when Frances was critically and terminally ill was having the capacity as a family to come together and just have those conversations. And I think if we were to do it over again, or God forbid the next time, I would encourage us to do that with the help of an elder, and perhaps it depends who it is in the family, but perhaps the, you know, an elder, priest, or whomever, someone to help facilitate that conversation. It's a very difficult conversation to have, but I think it's really important.